Daily Morning Prayer, Monday, 10th May, 2021. Turn your face from my sins and blot out all my misdeeds. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts that we may obtain forgiveness by His infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in His presence to give thanks for all the great benefits we have received at His hands, to declare His most worthy praise, to hear His holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no help in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord, and grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. O Lord, open our lips, our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Hallelujah, the Lord is risen indeed. Come, let us adore him. Oh, be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not that we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Oh, go your ways into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. Alleluia. The Lord is risen indeed. O come, let us adore him. Psalm 50. The Lord, even the most mighty God, has spoken and called the world from the rising of the sun to the going down thereof. Out of Zion, perfect in her beauty, has God shone forth in glory. Our God shall come and shall not keep silence. There shall go before him a consuming fire, and a mighty tempest shall be stirred up round about him. He shall call to the heavens above and to the earth beneath, that he may judge his people. Gather my faithful together unto me, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. And the heavens shall declare his righteousness, for God himself is his judge. Hear, O Lord, my people, and I will speak, and I myself will testify against you, O Israel, for I am God, even your God. I will not rebuke you because of your sacrifices or for your burnt offerings, because they are always before me. I will take no bull calf out of your house, nor he goat out of your folds. For all the beasts of the forest are mine, and so are the cattle upon a thousand hills. I know all the birds of the air, and the wild beasts of the field are in my sight. If I were hungry, I would not tell you, for the whole world is mine, and all that is therein. Do you think that I will eat the flesh of bulls and drink the blood of goats? Offer unto God a sacrifice of thanksgiving, and pay your vows unto the Most High, and call upon me in the time of trouble, so will I hear you, and you shall praise me. But to the ungodly, God says, why do you recite my laws and take my covenant in your mouth? Though you hate to be disciplined and have cast my words behind you, when you saw a thief, you agreed with him, and you have taken part with adulterers. You have let your mouth speak wickedness, and with your tongue you have set forth deceit. You sat and spoke against your brother, yes, and have slandered your own mother's son. These things you have done, and I held my tongue, and you thought wickedly that I am such as one as yourself. These things you have done, and I held my tongue, and you thought wickedly that I am such a one as yourself. But I will reprove you and set before you the things that you have done. Oh, consider this, you who forget God, lest I tear you in pieces and there be none to deliver you. Whoever offers me a sacrifice of thanksgiving honors me, and to him who orders his way aright, I will show the salvation of God. Psalm 51. Have mercy upon me, O God, in your great goodness, according to the multitude of your mercies. Wipe away my offenses. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my faults, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned and done this evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence, blameless in your judgment. But behold, you desire truth in the inward parts, and shall make me understand wisdom secretly. You shall purge me of the hyssop, and I shall be clean. You shall wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. You shall make me hear of joy and gladness, that the bones which you have broken may rejoice. Turn your face from my sins, and blot out all my misdeeds. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. O give me the comfort of your help again, and sustain me with your willing spirit. Then shall I teach your ways unto the wicked, and sinners shall return unto you. Deliver me from blood guilt, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, my mouth shall show forth your praise. For you desire no sacrifice, or else I would give it to you, but you delight not in burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a troubled spirit, a broken and contrite heart. O God, you shall not despise. O be favorable and gracious unto Zion, and you build up the walls of Jerusalem. Then you shall be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with the burnt offerings and oblations. Then shall they offer your bulls. Psalm 52. Why do you boast, you tyrant, that you can do evil, whereas the goodness of God endures all the day long? Your tongue devises wickedness, and with lies you cut like a sharp razor. You have loved unrighteousness more than goodness, and to utter lies more than truth. You have loved to speak all words that hurt, O you deceitful tongue. Therefore, God shall destroy you forever. He shall catch you and pluck you out of your dwelling, and root you out of the land of the living. The righteous also shall see this and fear, and shall laugh him to scorn. Behold, this is the one who did not take God for his strength, but trusted in the multitude of his riches and relied on his wickedness. As for me, I am like a green olive tree in the house of God. My trust is in the tender mercy of God forever and ever. I will always give thanks unto you for what you have done, and I will declare your name among the faithful, for it is good. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. as it was in the beginning, is now, and never shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy, beginning with the 11th chapter, the first verse. You shall therefore love the Lord your God and keep his charge, his statutes, his rules, and his commandments always. And consider today, since I am not speaking to your children who have not known or seen it, consider the discipline of the Lord your God, his greatness, his mighty hand and his outstretched arm, his signs and his deeds that he did in Egypt to Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, and to all his land, and what he did to the army of Egypt, to their horses and to their chariots, how he made the water of the Red Sea flow over them as they pursued after you, and how the Lord has destroyed them to this day, and what he did to you in the wilderness until you came to this place, and what he did to Dathan and Abiram, the sons of Eliab, the sons of Reuben, how the earth opened its mouth and swallowed them up with their households, their tents, and every living thing that followed them in the midst of all Israel. For your eyes have seen all the great work of the Lord that he did. You shall therefore keep the whole commandment that I command you today, that you may be strong and go in and take possession of the land that you are going over to possess, and that you may live long in the land that the Lord swore to your fathers to give to them and to their offspring, a land flowing with milk and honey. For the land that you are entering to take possession of it is not like the land of Egypt from which you have come, where you sowed your seed and irrigated it like a garden of vegetables. But the land that you are going over to possess is a land of hills and valleys which drinks water by the rain from heaven, a land that the Lord your God cares for. The eyes of the Lord your God are always upon it, from the beginning of the year to the end of the year. And if you will indeed obey my commandments that I command you today, to love the Lord your God and to serve him with all your heart and with all your soul, he will give the rain of your land in its season, the early rain and the later rain, that you may gather in your grain and your wine and your oil. And he will give grass in your fields for your livestock, and you shall eat and be full. Take care lest your heart be deceived, and you turn aside and serve other gods and worship them. Then the anger of the Lord will be kindled against you, and he will shut up the heavens so that there will be no rain, and the land will yield no fruit, and you will perish quickly off the good land that the Lord is giving you. You shall therefore lay up these words of mine in your heart and in your soul, and you shall bind them as a sign on your forehead, on your hand, that they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. You shall teach them to your children, talking of them when you are sitting in your house, and when you are walking by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. You shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates, that your days and the days of your children may be multiplied in the land that the Lord swore to your fathers to give them, as long as the heavens are above the earth. For if you will be careful to do all this commandment that I command you to do, loving the Lord your God, walking in all his ways and holding fast to him, then the Lord will drive out all these nations before you, and you will dispossess nations greater and mightier than you. Every place on which the sole of your foot treads shall be yours. The territory shall be from the wilderness to the Lebanon, and from the river Euphrates to the western sea. No one shall be able to stand against you. The Lord your God will lay the fear of you, the dread of you, on all the land that you shall tread, as he promised you. See, I am setting before you today a blessing and a curse. The blessing, if you obey the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command you today, and the curse, if you do not obey the commandments of the Lord your God, but turn aside from the way that I am commanding you today to go after other gods that you have not known. And when the Lord your God brings you into the land that you are entering to take possession of it, you shall set the blessing on Mount Gerizim, the curse on Mount Ebal. Are they not beyond the Jordan, west of the road toward the going down of the sun, in the land of the Canaanites who live in the Araba opposite Gilgal, beside the oak of Morah? For you are to cross over the Jordan to go in to take possession of the land that the Lord your God is giving you. And when you possess it and live in it, you shall be careful to do all the statutes and the rules that I am setting before you today. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense. He will be my savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day you shall say, give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the peoples, that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion, ring out your joy, for the great one in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as was in the beginning, and is now, and ever shall be. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, beginning with the 6th chapter, the 39th verse. He also told them a parable. Can a blind man lead a blind man? Will they not both fall into a pit? A disciple is not above his teacher, but everyone, when he is fully trained, will be like his teacher. Why do you see the speck that is in your brother's eye, but do not notice the log that is in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, brother, let me take out the speck that is in your eye, when you yourself do not see the log that is in your own eye? You hypocrite, first take out the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take out the speck that is in your brother's eye. For no good tree bears bad fruit, nor again does a bad tree bear good fruit. For each tree is known by its own fruit. For figs are not gathered from thorn bushes, nor are grapes plucked from a bramble bush. The good person, out of the good treasure of his heart, produces good, and the evil person, out of his evil treasure, produces evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not do what I tell you? Everyone who comes to me and hears my words and does them, I will show you what he is like. He is like a man building a house who dug deep and laid the foundation on the rock. And when a flood arose, the stream broke against that house and could not shake it because it had been well built. But the one who hears and does not do them, is like a man who built a house on the ground without a foundation. When the stream broke against it, immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great. After he had finished all those sayings in the hearing of the people, he entered Capernaum. Now a centurion had a servant who was sick and at the point of death, who was highly valued by him. When the centurion heard about Jesus, he sent to him elders of the Jews, asking him to come and heal his servant. And when they came to Jesus, they pleaded with him earnestly, saying, He is worthy to have you do this for him, for he loves our nation, and he is the one who built us our synagogue. And Jesus went to with them. And he was not far from the house, the centurion's friend saying to him, Lord, do not trouble yourself, for I am not worthy to have you come under my roof. Therefore, I did not presume to come to you, but say the word and let my servant be healed, for I too am a man set under authority, with soldiers under me. And I say to one, go, and he goes, and to another, come, and he comes, and to my servant, do this, and he does it. When Jesus heard these things, he marveled at him, and turning to the crowd that followed him, said, I tell you, not even in Israel have I found such faith. And when those who have been sent returned to the house, they found the servant well. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, that great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are the ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and was seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord have mercy, Christ have mercy, Lord have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us. Grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us. Lead us the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O people, save your people. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the people of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, Lord of heaven and earth, we humbly pray that your gracious providence may give and preserve to our use the harvests of the land and of the seas, and may prosper all who labor to gather them. That we, who are constantly receiving good things from your hand, may always give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as surpass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love towards you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the eternal, the King eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires, incline our hearts to keep your law, and guide our feet into the way of peace, that having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. O God the Father, Creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God the Son, Redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God the Holy Spirit, Sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, Blessed and Glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood. By your mercy, preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation. Good Lord, deliver us from all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, from all lack of charity. Good Lord, deliver us from all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil. Good Lord, deliver us from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart, and contempt of your word, and commandments. Good Lord, deliver us from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine. Good Lord, deliver us from all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, from dying suddenly and unprepared. Good Lord, deliver us by the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to your law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation. Good Lord, deliver us by your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial. Good Lord, deliver us by your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory. Good Lord, deliver us in all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment. Good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your holy church universal in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To illumine all bishops, priests, the knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living, they may show it accordingly. Teach you to hear us, good Lord, to send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving welfare unto all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, and to give all your people increase and grace to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bring into the way of truth all who have heard and deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep all your people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to rule the hearts of your servants, our national leaders, and all others who are bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, and to shield them in all dangers and adversities. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and protect all who serve their communities by their support. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give and preserve for us and for others this fountain of fruits of the earth, so that as our harvest we call and enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and prosperity. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless, and the poor. all those who have done I seek you to hear us. Preserve all who are in danger by means of the work of travel. I seek you to hear us, my Lord. Strengthen the bonds of those in holy worship of peace to uphold the widow and the offender, to uphold all those who want to avoid strife. I seek you to hear us, my Lord, to protect the poor and the parents, to preserve all women and childbirth. Beseech you to hear us before, to care for those who have lost children in faith and fertility, and to provide for young children and orphans. We beseech you to hear us before, to visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer and remind us, to comfort with your presence those who are feeling it. We beseech you to hear us before, to support and help and deliver all who are in danger and necessity. That it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin and negligence and deviations, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to your holy word. We beseech you to hear us, O Lord, to forgive our enemies, persecute us, and despise us, and to turn their hearts. We beseech you to hear us, O Lord, to strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally, to beat down Satan under our feet. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to grant that in the fellowship of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, we may attain to your heaven. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. The Lamb of God, you take with us, and the Lord of God, you take with us. The Lamb of God, you take with us, and the Lord of heaven, you take with us. The Lamb of God, you take with us, and the Lord of grant all us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil, for the kingdom, the power, the glory of those now and forever. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for a new sin. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the many works that you did in their days, and the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for a new sin. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, as now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us from our sins. From our many evil offenders, O Christ, graciously withhold our afflictions. Let us busy with all the sorrows of our hearts, mercifully forgive the sins of the people. In this favor, hear our prayers, O Son of David, and as we come. Be pleased and hear us, O Christ. Let us pray. Let us pray, O Father, our heart and our teachings, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils we have endured, and we grant that in all the troubles we may put our full trust and confidence in your presence, so that we can give you the greatness and purity of life to your honor and glory through our only being, Jesus Christ, our Lord. In this time of grievous sickness, we flee to you for comfort. Deliver us, we beseech you, from our peril. Give strength and skill to all those who minister to the sick. Prosper the meek, make use of for the cure, and grant that, perceiving how frail and uncertain our life is, we may apply our hearts into that heavenly wisdom which leads to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Almighty God, by your word, you laid the foundations of the earth, set the bounds of the sea, and still the wind and waves. Surround us with your grace and peace, and preserve us through this plague. By your spirit, lift up those who fall.
So that's what the whole DMPH, which is this part of my father of our presence, we are on the service of the Father's all your goodness and all your needs to us and to all the human beings. Bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your blessings, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all your days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit.